Zach Riel and Don Thompson Jr. occupy the front row as we go to the green flag here in Mérida, near the largest city of the Yucatan state of Mexico. And Riel and Don Thompson Jr. both had kind of bad starts, and Ryder Smith really got the jump on both of them. He's going after Riel already as Thompson Jr. gets shoved back to fourth after perhaps as Louvier and Smith are trying to team up to perhaps get first and second. Riel will lead the very first lap. Things awfully tight in the midfield as always at the start of these races. Washer gets into the back of Engritz. Engritz swerves around a little, managed to save that car before turn one, and managed to pass Fullerton and perhaps Little John in the process. Impressive job as they're still battling for the lead up there. Bunch of roses, three wide racing. I believe this is going into lap number four, actually, and they're still side-by-side for that first position. Smith might be able to get through. If he can just clear, he might get him here. Down into turn three, Riel tries to squeeze him down just a little, but Smith is still able to remain strong, and with a big push from Louvier off the corner, I think Smith got him. Louvier underneath the 33 for that second position might finally be able to get it done. Riel's been stuck up there all race long and hasn't seemed to just... he's been getting good runs off the corner, but you simply can't compete with that inside line a lot of the time. It's just so much shorter around this half-mile dirt track. You could fit most of these cars under a blanket right now as Wilhoit gets into Fingai. And Stringer sent down the racetrack over the earth wall and actually flips the car there in the 87. He's got it back going again. Impressive job by him. Fingai tries to get himself back on the racing service and gets stuck perched on the earth wall there. He's going to need a tow. Stringer back onto the racing service, doesn't even bother going to the pits. And the green flag stays out for some reason through all of this. On board Bill Littlejohn, a short track driver from the northwestern United States. He's definitely got to be familiar with this type of racetrack, as is Don Thompson Jr. He's currently who Littlejohn's currently going around. Thompson Jr., of course, a driver of the NASCAR Canadian Tire Series, prior driver of the NASCAR Canadian Tire Series before moving over into this series. And now Littlejohn sets his sights on Shrimp Engritz, who's having a surprisingly good run to start the day here today. A very good race for 14th place currently between Spencer Fullerton and Jacob Young, a pair of longtime veterans of HARC racing, and Johnny Appleseed trying to get by the 22 to perhaps get himself a top 10 here today. Fitzwater having a pretty good run so far up inside the top 20. Definitely something he's going to be proud of, considering the season he's had. Alex Allen, though, gets by Johnny Appleseed and Jacob Young perhaps in one fell swoop, as Fullerton really putting a gap on these guys because of their hard racing. Still three wide for that position. Fitzwater, Young, and Sanchez going at it as Wheeler gets into the 18 and Ty Dent slides down the racetrack into the earth wall, and Marcus Stroman just barely saves it before making some contact with Alex Wheeler, and that will finally bring the first caution out. Green flag back out on lap number 24 of 60. Ryder Smith, driving for Red Viper Racing, has been fairly dominant so far. He made his pass to get into the lead in the very first corner, actually. Didn't manage to get it done until around lap 4, but since then he has been driving away just a little bit from the rest of the field. Rusty Babinski wants to change this, so he's charged his way into the top 5, actually made his way into the podium, and is now making his way past Zach Riel for second position. James O'Shea alongside the 33 down into turn number 3. That's probably going to take a little while. Riel might be able to hold him off for now, though, if he can get back down to the inside. Riel seems to be running fairly well on the outside. Doesn't seem to be giving up the charge on Rusty Babinski, and that's a really bad idea because James O'Shea just keeps diving it on in there. Chris Washer currently sitting at the tail end of the top 5, but perhaps not for long, as Ty Dent, a notable short track racer, is making his way towards the front as well. At the extreme tail end of the field, we have DJ Curtis. As per usual, he's pretty far down in points. Maxwell Chan, he's dead last, I think, or damn near dead last. Kim Markell and TJ Dent are also back here. Dent, of course, back here because of his earlier spin. Finn Guy trying to make his way forward, although he is the only car one lap down. He went a couple of laps down, actually, during his tow back to the pits. And Matthew Stringer, despite rolling that car, has not brought it into the pits and kept it on the lead lap before that. Caution as Dent slides up the racetrack. Whoa! Stringer has to swerve to avoid. No caution for this, as Dent somehow kept that thing off the wall. Great car control by the driver, the number 18. They're showing why he is a bit of a notable dirt track racer. But as I was saying about Matthew Stringer, still managed to get a pass done on Nick Pericles despite the interesting damage on that number 87 car. Zeus Morrow and Chris Louvier were a pair of drivers that were right up in the thick of things at the very beginning of this race, but have slowly moved their way outside the top 10. Now they're around 15th and 16th respectively, but not for long. Jeff Derry trying to get by for that position. Bill Littlejohn also trying to perhaps make his way up a spot here. Trying to follow Derry through, manages to get underneath him there. And Louvier stuck, still getting fright trained on the outside. Once you get stuck up there, it's kind of hard to do much of anything except just try and get the position back on those straightaways where the outside certainly has the better run. Battles on for second as Riel, Rusty Babinski, and James O'Shea go at it for that position. Ryder Smith has kept a fairly constant gap on those drivers, of about five car lengths, just minding his P's and Q's, perhaps saving his stuff in case one of these charging drivers has anything for him in the final few laps. Here's a few drivers we haven't talked too much about so far this race. Alex Tanker currently running about 20th place in that number 15, not the kind of a run he's used to on these short tracks. Most of his five or six wins have come on these sort of racetracks. Tristan Wilhoit also back here. Another disappointing run for that Discover Alaska Autosports team. Rusty Babinski's car appears to be falling off in a hurry. He's been overtaken by Ty Dent and Chris Washer since Zach Riel and James O'Shea got by him just a few laps ago. Matthew Nicholson now quickly closing in on that 41's bumper. 41 certainly not slow, but doesn't appear to have a car to keep within the top five. O'Shea just drove by the number 33 for that second position. He's got a somewhat significant gap to close on the number 7, and Riel now goes back to try and get that pass done once again. This is exactly what Smith wants to see as the laps are beginning to dwindle down, coming to around 11 or 12 laps to go this time. Quick field flyby with around 10 laps to go. Washer trying to make his move on James O'Shea. Johnny Appleseed trying to get past, I believe that's Zeus Morrow. It appears as Maxwell Chan and Zachary Fitzwater battle for a surprisingly good spot for them. Yet another race for second position is underway here as James O'Shea and Zach Riel side by side once again. Washer trying to follow O'Shea into third, breaking up these two perhaps, as Smith again just a constant gap there between himself and the rest of the field onto the back straightaway here. White flag out for Ryder Smith in the number 7. James O'Shea has been setting some really fast laps trying to catch that number 7, but the 7 has really stepped up his game. He has posted his fastest lap of the race as we came to the white flag. And James O'Shea has one lap, final dive into the final corner, runs a tiny bit wide, and it's the 7 of Ryder Smith, who dominates race number 1 to come home with his very first victory. O'Shea will grab second, around half a second back of Smith's bumper. Washer, another great run for him. A third place finish here in Mexico. it will be Zachriel with that fourth place finish. He battled O'Shea and Washer all race long for that position. A solid run for Dent in fifth. Alex Allen made his way forward into sixth position. Rusty Babinski maintained seventh. Matthew Nicholson in eighth. Jose Bautista and Shrimp Engritz will actually round out the top 10 there. Zeus Moro a close 11th. After a relatively clean race number one, Pichu London and Carlin Dumian would lead the field to the green for race number two. London with a great start over Carlin Dumian. Andy Thomas not able to make the move to the inside like Ryder Smith did so early in race number one. And London will come across line two, lead lap number one. Three wide for around 15th position, Kane Thanos and Sydney Krasta going forward. Krasta all over the back end of the number nine is Allie Nelson gets turned down the racetrack. And Kane back up into traffic and a whole ton of cars into the wall. And this first caution out way earlier than the first caution in race number one. Mark Howell and Thanos already made contact even before the incident took place. After the contact, Kane would be sent up the racetrack into Markel, and that would send Markel, Andreas Allen, Luco Brovac, Mark Nutt, Sawyer Girl, and Fala Thanos into the wall, ending a few of their days and severely hampering the others. Pichu London returns the field to the restart, and Andy Thomas with an immediate dive down into turn number one. Thomas looking to get that position in a real hurry here. Duncan's also in the top three. He might jump down underneath London to try and get second if Thomas is successful. Fala Thanos, Andreas Allen, Sawyer Girl, and Mark Nutt are out of the race because of this incident. As Sam Morrow has come to a stop on the racing service. He must have had a mechanical failure, and he will get a tow back to the pits. Going to go several laps down, but I think he might be able to get that thing fixed, I'm hearing. Thomas and London still side by side. Matt Duncan took a peek to the middle for just a second. I don't think he thought that would be successful as Duncan actually gets real loose off of turn number two and has a swerve to avoid the left rear quarter panel of London. Great move by him to avoid an unnecessary incident. Carlin Dumian doing a whole lot better than his teammate did in race number one, up here in fourth, along with Kerry Davis. Actually, Kerry Davis just took fourth from Carlin Dumian, and the caution is back out. We're only a sixth of the way through, and already we've had more contact than we've had in race number one, as contact with Gerald Reddington and Luke Walker sent Cameron Gadu and Amin Al-Ghul down, spinning down into the inside wall. That will hamper their days. But I suppose that'll give Luca Obrovac and some of the other damaged cars a little bit of competition. At the line, it will be Thomas leading the field to the caution flag by just a hundredth of a second. Really close battle between these two the last few laps, and it will be Thomas who wins out for now. Annie Thomas returns the field to the green flag. Matt Duncan going after London already. Those Jeff Gordon restarts really hurting the 007 car. Kerry Davis and Carlin Dumian continue to perhaps battle for fourth here as Davis runs a tiny bit wide. Yep, Carlin Dumian going up, trying to go up the inside. And it's William Duncan in sixth position. So far, so good for the driver of that number six machine. Quite a chaotic race compared to the calm, cool, and collected race number one. Matt Duncan may have gotten by the 007, but the 007 does still appear to be the faster car. Once you get going, and it's London who pulls the crossover move to get that position back. Sam Curtis and James Silver Fox racing side by side for around 11th. Mike Doan squeezes his way between both of them. He's trying to get past Silver Fox as Curtis tries to squeeze him up to the outside as far as he can. As it appears, Doan will get by Silver Fox, but Curtis will maintain his position so far. Faber going by the number 27 car, Sydney Krasta, who mostly triggered the incident on lap number two, also still having a good run to the dismay of many of his competitors. Nicholas Amadio looking for a good point stay in that number 47 car. A good run today with Gerald Reddington where he is right now might give that driver the points lead. As he drives by the number 6 of William Duncan. Duncan back to 8th, but still a great run for him. I'm sure he'd still be happy with anything inside the top 10. London going for a pass for the lead here on Annie Thomas. He's closed in on Annie since getting by the number 99 of Matt Duncan. Matt Duncan also closing in on the number 93. But this really shows the speed that the 007 car has. It took several laps for the 93 of Annie Thomas, who got to the inside of London on the opening lap to get by that 007 machine. And yet within a lap, Pichu London has gotten by the 93 and gapped him just by a couple of car lengths. Pair of mangled racing machines racing for around 23rd. Tyler Markell and Luca Obrovac still making their way up a few positions despite their damage. Luca Obrovac in particular has a bent up hood that I can't believe he can even see out of that car. He probably has his big nose outside the side window there, just trying to take a peek. Since the lap 10 crash that he was partially a part of, Gerald Reddington has charged his way up a bunch of positions in that number 112 car, trying to close in on that 47 to prevent Samadio from taking the points lead. DJ Harris also just behind the 112. These two have been working together to try and pick off some cars. Markell gets turned by the 9 on the front straightaway. This will bring out the third caution of the race as Sam Morrow swerves to avoid that number 10 car. Second major crash for Markell so far. The front's mangled, the back's mangled. Probably can't see out the rearview mirror, but he's still going. Just 22 laps to go for London. He might get his first true victory here today. He won a heat race back in Talladega last year by 2/1000ths of a second. That's the only success he's had, is Demir Bezhenov gets turned down the racetrack. I think he might have saved that, but we'll have to check. Off of turn number 2, Terrence Day into the back of the 13. The 13 rides the earth wall, stays on the right side of it, and somehow gets it turned for turn number 3. Unbelievable job by Demir Bezhenov to hold on to that race car and not come spearing back up the racetrack into Terrence Day. Also some good patience on his part to not intentionally spear back up the racetrack into Day, and he will still manage to perhaps get that pass done for fourth position. It's Nicholas Samadio and Matt Duncan now make it 3 wide with Terrence Day for that position. Nicholas Samadio wants a top 5 to confirm his points lead exiting today if he can stay where he is, and Gerald Reddington remains where he is. Tyler Markell has been coming in and out of the pits virtually every lap for the last bunch, just trying to get that car into a shape where he can continue to race. It doesn't come in this lap, seeing what he can do with that car. It appears to be still relatively on pace. He's really holding up the 007 of Pichu London. I'm sure London's not too happy about this, as London tried to get around the outside of the 10 to no success, got tight and had to get off the throttle. And Kerry Davis closing in on a hurry as Markell heads to pit road, and that checks up the 007. Here comes the 13 for the lead, and whoa, look at this. And there's a swarm of cars surrounding the 007 into the corner. They were nearly 4 wide for the lead going into turn number 1. London will still come out with the lead, but it's the 13 of Demir Bezhenov still underneath. Will not be able to get the job done for now on the inside. London's car is just too strong. Duncan back into third, as we've got about 8 cars under a blanket here. London's starting to pull away just a little bit. Nicholas Samadio, Kerry Davis, and Annie Thomas going for 5th position at this point. Markell back out on the racetrack about a lap later. Tries to get down pit road, but Reddington's inside of him, and that causes a big chain reaction stack-up incident, and Reddington with some damage. Faber with some damage. Markell finally makes it onto pit road, and I believe Morrow also got a piece. Just 8 to go on the restart here as London tries to hold off Demir Bezhenov and a hungry group of cars behind him. Bezhenov really really got helped by Markell's checkup into turn number three a few laps ago. Closed in on that 007, but his car simply doesn't appear to be on the same level as Pichu London, as London continues to pull away just a little bit. Matt Duncan trying to get back underneath the 13 for second. Nicholas Samadio going for third on the number 13 with just three to go here. Andrew Ricks made his way up into the top four late as Markell's still on the racetrack. Oh, great. Okay, as Duncan has to check up behind the number 10, trying to get by him here. Please don't come in. Okay, huge stack up there as Markell comes down pit road. And now they're three wide for the second position. Make that four wide. Nicholas Samadio, right in the middle of it, one of the championship contenders, tries to get between Rick and Duncan as London is long gone because of this. And I believe we're coming to the white flag this time. Andrew Rick managed to get second, the beneficiary of all of that. No, two laps to go, rather, for Rick here as he gets by Duncan. It's a ferocious battle for around 10th position with just one lap to go. Markell still back onto the racing service trying to get that car working. I really don't know why he just didn't put that thing behind the wall. But up front, it's all Pichu London as he will come off the final corner to finally get his first round victory here in the 007 car. Definitely the fastest car of this heat race. 3 seconds back, it's Andrew Rick, who really put a gap on Kerry Davis, Matt Duncan, and the rest of the field. He might have been able to challenge Pichu London without all that Markell shenanigans. It would be Kerry Davis coming across the line in third, Matt Duncan a close fourth, and Nicholas Samadio will actually get a top five here in that 47 car, and he will take the points lead with Reddington well back. Terrence Day will finish sixth. The Demir Bajianov in the 13th, 7th place finish. DJ Harris, Annie Thomas, and Sydney Carrasta will round out the top 10.